Candlelight. It's our 43rd year for this event. It's a Dallas tradition. Many families come here year after year after year. We even have examples of families who remember coming here as children, and they're now bringing their children to Candlelight. So for a lot of Dallas families, this is their kickoff to the holidays. So all of our buildings are decorated. We have entertainment.
The king wins his lost his crown on the feast of Stephen.
We have a bake sale, we have kettle corn, and of course candles lighting all of our pathways. It's also one of our largest public fundraisers. So this is not just about doing it for the community, but it also helps support all of our other programs throughout the rest of the year. We have sponsors that help support this event, and every ticket goes to overall programming as well. So our mission is to both preserve, to preserve these buildings and our collection, and use them to teach our community about history and what life in North Texas was like between 1840 and 1910. We see all ages here. There's plenty of babies, and there's plenty of people that may have great-grandchildren, and that's one of the great things about this event too, is it's very family-friendly. It's 2 days, 3 p.m. to 9 p.m. each day. Typically, our biggest night is Saturday night. There's at least 50 or 60 people making this work right this minute. And they are what we call history educators, so they're acting as if they live in a certain period of time to help teach about the past. But we also have some volunteer reenactors here tonight as well, including some Civil War guys. I believe the first U.S. is here tonight, so it's a hobby for some of these people, and this is a great place for them to have fun with their hobby. The bake sale, our GIL, which is our volunteer auxiliary group, they bake and bake and bake. And that bake sale last year was one of their best years ever, and they raised $5,000 mostly on dollar bags of cookies. So just do the math on the amount of flour and sugar and butter and eggs and time. And it's pretty amazing. The trains are a newer addition to Candlelight. This is their third year, I believe, and Ron Siebler is part of a model train club, and he brings his layout here to Dallas Heritage Village. And it's just a great thing. He loves showing off his collection and sharing it, and it's what better place for them than the depot.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
1 year we did not have kettle corn, and we learned very quickly that all we really needed for Candlelight was kettle corn and candles, and people would be happy. So kettle corn is also one of the most popular vendors for sure. There's been a line all night, and it's delicious. You should have some. Nip and Tuck, typically most popular employees at Dallas Heritage Village. You know, there's a lot of ways to support us. The easiest way and the way to get started is becoming a member. And then you get complimentary Candlelight tickets, as well as can come other times throughout the year. So that's the easiest way to get started, but there's lots of different ways, both big and small, and we'll put your money to good work. You know, the thing about Dallas Heritage Village, unlike some of the other Dallas cultural institutions, is we're fairly small. So your money can have a big impact here.